And now a few items from our Freedom Files. There's a new Long Beach, California Police Department policy. You ready for this? Take a picture in public that lacks, quote, apparent aesthetic value, according to the cops, and they'll detain you. This comes after an incident earlier this summer where Long Beach Post photographer Sandra Wolf was detained after taking a picture of an oil refinery. The police admit the force does not undergo any kind of training to help it determine whether a photograph has aesthetic value. Come on, this policy is an extension of the police rubric for suspicious activity reports, which aims to record anything that could indicate activity or intentions related to either foreign or domestic terrorism. Gee, that's funny. The last time I checked, taking a picture doesn't mean someone was intent on committing an act of terrorism. It usually means the person is a tourist, or in this case, a journalist. And the last time I checked, the Constitution still protected the right of free expression, which means the police cannot legally sanction items lacking in aesthetic value. Take whatever pictures you want in public. Cutting off cell phone service to prevent potential protests is the foreign policy of dictators, right? Well, not exactly. Sadly, this is a policy used in America, too. On Friday last week, San Francisco BART officials, those in charge of the city's public transportation system, admitting to doing just that as a way to prevent communications between various groups who plan to assemble in protest of a shooting in which a BART police officer fatally killed a man earlier this month. Have San Francisco's bureaucrats forgotten that the people have a right to assemble, even if they disagree with the government? And since when are America's police forces taking tips from foreign dictators? The police and the goons that run the transit system in San Francisco have all taken the same oath to uphold the Constitution, which insulates free speech from the government. So why then do the people there let the government operate as though they're being paid to trample on free speech?